Hello, hello, hello. It's your boy once again, Ambassador Ambassador. Just stopped by to do a quick review on the track Super Large just put out Last Supper. So it's crazy, yeah, because I'm going with the same narrative, Champions League of Africa. You know, like in the Champions League, we have the big teams, the Manchester, the Juventus, AC Milan, and the rest, which are, I mean, these teams are always there and we already know them, so they come with all chances that the big shots here. Then we have the underdogs who always pop up now and then, and we discover them in the Champions League. Like, if you are a Premier League fan, you'll know like the big teams and the small teams. But when it comes to like Bundesliga or Spanish League or La Liga, all those other places, you don't know the small teams. You just know like the Monaco, PSG, Lyon, and things like that. But now, when it's the Champions League, when the small team has a chance to come to the Champions League, then even those who are fans of the Premiership or La Liga are going to discover this team, even if the team is from France. I don't know if you see what I'm saying. So I just feel like this is that place where every small, or let's say smaller name, if you jump into the conversation and you represent good enough, then you get your chance to shine in the Champions League, and then you get considered amongst the Real Madrids and the Manchester United and all the greats here. So that's what Judas was trying to do, because I felt I'm not that versed with the Ugandan hip-hop scene. So I was just like, okay, maybe Judas is one of the big names. But when I looked at his subscriptions and his social media things, I was like, okay, maybe he's not that big, but they should have bigger guys. And then now when Super Large takes shots at him, like the intro, Super Large was, he went heavy on, the whole place is littered with biblical allusions. He went heavy with biblical allusions. I mean, like from the cover art, it was the Last Supper, the Last Supper, you know, like from the Bible, the Last Supper Judas had, Jesus had with his disciples, Judas Iscariot being one of them. That's already likening Judas the rapper to Judas Iscariot. He called him a couple of times Judas Iscariot. You know, he betrayed Jesus Christ. His hand was cut in the basket during the Last Supper of Jesus Christ. And Jesus Christ said the person who's going to put their hand at the same time in the basket with bread or something like that, he's going to betray me. Yeah. So that's the whole story, Judas. So the Last Supper, that was the cover art which he used. And then he went with shots on Judas here. Yeah. The open line to some kind of dialogue. I like that too, because that's a literary device here. There's some kind of dialogue between, he's acting out some kind of dialogue between himself and Cal De Niro. He's telling Cal De Niro like, relax, I've got this one. No need to go at this little kid. He in the beginning, he sounded like Cal De Niro didn't even know who Judas was. So he was telling Cal De Niro like, there's this guy, Judas, who is this? But don't be worried about him. I'll handle him for you and things like that. And that's what I like. I mean, like, it's strategy, yeah? So you have like maybe 5,000 subscription. Cal De Niro maybe has 20,000 subscriptions. And then maybe Judas has 10, and then he takes a shot at Cal De Niro. Cal De Niro might have heavy lines. I feel like that's what even the whole Sarkodie, what's his name, Lyrical Joe thing was going all about. They might not be in the same house, the same level at the same time, but Lyrical Joe would take a shot at people who are taking shots at Sarkodie, because he does not want Sarkodie. And if you are one of his guys, you don't want him to go at these guys and give them the shine. So you just take the shot on his behalf. And then if you represent good enough, you get the views, because you with 5,000 views taking a shot at somebody with 10,000 views, if he replies to you, then you get rubbed off in the level of the 10,000 views. But now if your person with 20,000 views replies to him, then he gets rubbed off at 20. So it's a whole game of chess thing I'm talking about all the time. So he said, no, Kyle should take it to relax. He's got this one. He mentioned him like Judas rap garbage instead of Judas rap knowledge guy. Then the interesting part where I said like Champions League, all these teams come together and we discover new names. Like, so he mentioned like he's not even the dope rapper from UG, that's Uganda. No one even knows him. So why is he the one making all the noise? So he mentioned the big rappers now like Navio, Big Thrill, and GNL. So I didn't even know these guys. I have seen like the Navio guy, I've seen one of his videos once on YouTube, I think maybe on MTV or something like that. And then Big Thrill, I remember like last year while I was in Kenya, it was blowing up the whole place, party after party. Yeah, I felt like it was a Kenyan artist. But now when I went to check each of these guys. I look at the Navio guy. I've seen your video before. I knew the face, but I didn't know the name. I looked at Big Tune, and then I saw Party After Party. I'm like, whoa, so this guy did this song, and now I'm discovering them. I went and checked the last guy, GNL Zamba guy. Amongst the three, he's like the most rapper-ish kind of guy, because some of the others are like more of dancey kind of things and not so much. Anyway, I've not listened to most of their catalog, so I can't really say. But from this few samples I did, GNL sounded like the most rapper kind of guy. And they have views, they have big views, I mean like at least decent views, yeah, and subscriptions. So they could and they should be big like that in Uganda. So I was like, okay, so Judas is not like a big thing out there, or he's not the biggest either way. So as I said, what's most interesting about this My Champions League of African Rappers is we get to discover the continent and we get to touch base with all these people, and then we're building a stronger market for Africa as a whole. Because I always tell African artists, like, if you want to compete with, I mean, just doing big like an American artist in Africa is going to give you that amount of money and that amount of strength of fame, yeah. But because we were at, by, I mean, back in the days, we were contented with like Cameroon, what was that, 22 million. Sierra Leone, I don't know what, 7 to 10 million, I don't know. Nigeria, yes, they have hundreds of million. But still, capital-wise and population-wise, America is almost like a continent put together. Yeah, number of states, capital-wise, they have heavy budgets and all of that. So you cannot really compare some of that kind of market, yeah. So most of the time, Africans, everything wise, I mean, even in business, the same thing should apply. We can really compete if we look at Africa as one market. So this is a very, for me, it's a very great move. It may sound like just beef, but for me, it's much more than that. I mean, we are breaking those frontiers. They just signed the, how do they even call it? It's the one market kind of thing in Africa. Now with mobile money things, currencies are crossing here and there. So I feel like it's very interesting times. I mean, there's much more to this than just the beef we are seeing right now. So I'm getting to discover all the other artists. And he said, he went he gave this kind of dialogue, like when he was in Kampala, he was like Judas, and people were like, Judas who? I mean, they don't even know Judas. So that's the narrative he's trying to go by, like they don't even know Judas in Kampala, that's the capital of Uganda, so that he's not the big name. So why is he making all this noise? Looking at the part where he's talking about how do you finish school, you have not finished school, then he's talking about Lyrica Joe, and I just felt like, whoa. I mean, like, it's just, maybe he didn't even write this down. It's in the heat of the moment, he just had to throw this punch. You know, like where you're punching your main target, and then some other friend who is maybe laughing at you or was laughing when this person was insulting you comes around, or you just see his face, you throw one extra punch on him. So it's just like this kind of random punches at aiming for Judas, but now Lyrica Joe just pops on. He's like, okay, just take some quick shots at Lyrica Joe and then gets back to business, which is Judas. So I said it before, I mean, these guys took shots at Sierra Leone, Lyrica Joe, and Judas did it again. So expect there was some every Sierra Leone rapper, yeah. So that was just Super Lash taking mad shots at Lyrica Joe. And all those taking shots at the Black Leo, I'm coming for you. So that's cool. I like his whole representation thing. I feel like it was a decent shot, but it was not like a crazy shot. Crazy shot in my sense, it could go very lyrical, like lots of bars and lots of punchlines and things. Or you could dig up a lot of dirt about him and then really, because beef is a whole thing of like, you dig up a lot of facts about the person. If the facts are a lot, you'll be like, whoa. You make a lot of fun of the person. I mean, like, you dig up these facts and then make fun of the person, trash him about his this, his that, his this. I mean, like, real things. So, I mean, like, there's work behind beef. So, for me, this was a decent shot. It was not that deep. It did not really make crazy fun of him, but it was a decent shot because he, rap-wise, his flow was good. And then I also checked him out, too. I was like, okay, he's not that big in Sierra Leone, but he's a decent rapper too. So Super Large, Last Supper, that was it. And I knew this was coming. I think I said it in my review of Judas, where I said the move where you take a shot at the whole country, that's just opening a kind of worms. Just hope there are no tough rappers in that country to take a crazy shot at you, because if not, you've just stepped on the whole country. You don't know who is who where. I mean, to take a general shot on the whole country, that's crazy. I mean, that's what even got guys like, and for me it's great, you know, because when you do that, I'm like, whoa, I want to like
repeat it over and over so that everybody in that country can hear, like, this is what they said about you guys, man. Say something about it. Like, that's what brought King B to the limelight, because when Lyrical Joe took a shot at Cameroon, King B couldn't sit back and watch this, even if Jovi did not take a direct shot. So King B took a direct shot at Lyrical Joe, and that's what brought him to the shine. And then he did a collabo with Cal De Niro, who is a big name in Sierra Leone, and now he even has more fans in Sierra Leone than in Cameroon. So you just see the way those things are moving. I feel like these are interesting times, man. Same story out there. Champions League of African Rappers is going on now, and there I feel like I'm some kind of commentator. I'm looking for the name I'm going to use of a big commentator of the Champions Leagues, yeah. But I think that's what I'm doing, giving the commentaries on the Champions League, like, oh, every life, yeah. So I don't want to miss out on anything. Anything you see out there, just make a comment to Chakara TV so we pick it up, and then we are keeping up with the various games at every level, yeah. Okay, it's your boy Ambassador. I'm out.